Welcome to MCOM second semester research methodology subject. Dear students, my name is Dr. K.V. Swaminath, GS College of Commerce, Vartha, your teacher for research methodology. After the completion of the unit 1, today we start with the unit 2. And this lesson 11 is going to discuss about the research problem selection, which is the first and very prime and foremost step in the research process. A research problem is a question that a researcher wants to answer or a problem that a researcher wants to solve. A research problem is an issue or a concern that an investigator or the researcher presents and justifies in a research study. So, in a nutshell, what we can understand is the journey between two points. One is what should be happening and what is actually happening. In between these two, there is some logical question, and that logical question is arising due to a problem, and that has been to be called as the problem statement, which is called as the research problem statement or definition of the research problem. So what is this actually? Identification and formulation of a research problem is the first step of the research process. It is the most challenging and difficult phase of the research process. Now, how to select a research problem? The selection of a research problem depends on several factors, such as the knowledge of the researcher, the skill set of the researcher, the interests of a researcher, the expertise and the efficiency levels of an expertiser or a researcher. Next, the motivation and creativity do exist among the researchers, and the subject which is of interesting and motivating among the researchers. If it is okay, if it is motivating, then there will be more and more effectiveness in the selection of a research problem. Now, a good research studies needs a lot of time for selection of research problem. Initially, every researcher faces a predicament of identifying, selecting and formulating a good research problem. In other words, a research problem is an area of concern where there is a gap in the knowledge base needed for professional practices. So then what is a research problem? A research problem and the problem statement are frequently used as synonyms. However, there are a lot of differences between these two, that is the research problem and the problem statement. Now, if you go through this particular diagram, a research question may be from four angles. One is from the purpose angle, the second is from the theoretical aspect point, the third one is sampling strategy point, and the methods, research methods what applied from that angle also. So, in a nutshell, a research question is going to be discussed from four angles: the purpose, the theory, the sampling strategy, and the methods adopted to answer the research questions. Then what are the components of a research problem? Then in an overall way, we can say that there are six elements or six parts or the six components in a research problem. What are they? One is the relevance of the study. Second, the title of the study. Third one is operational definitions of the variables. Fourth one is objectives of the study. Fifth one, delimitations of the study. And the sixth one is scope and limitations of the study. Now, how to identify the research problem? The identification of the research problem is the first step. Generally, a broad area is selected and then it is delimited or narrowed down to a specific one statement or sentence to depict the research problem. So, we'll come from macro level to micro level or the niche level, such that the problem is go on narrowed and narrowed and narrowed, and finally a particular point of identification will come, and that will become the research problem. Then what are the sources of the research problem? So there are several sources for the formulation of the research problem. The first one is the personal experience. If a person feels that okay, this may be a problem. Second one is practical experience, which has encountered during his course of experiencing with the outside environment. The critical appraisal of the literature, previous research, existing theories, social issues, brainstorming sessions, intuitions, folklore, exposure to field situation, and consultation with experts. These are all several areas generally which may originate the research problem or which may act as the source for the research problem. Now let us go one by one. Personal experience. Day-to-day experience of the researcher serves as a good source of ideas to formulate the research. Generally, if a researcher goes on experiencing some problems during his course of doing the research or encountering with the external environment in the society or in the industry or the workplace, generally on one day, the researcher feels that there is a need to go for searching into this and researching into this, and finally goes for conducting the research to find out the solutions to the problems what he or she has encountered during their experience. The practical experience. Sometimes when they go and conduct the actions and activities apart from their duty, they encounter some inexperiences or some problems while serving these things or doing their discharging their duties. So just like the doctors, they go and treat a particular patient, and after some time they feel that no, the drugs which are being specified for solution may not be optimum. Then they look into that, and naturally after some time they themselves go into search and research for identical solutions for the experienced problems. So in the case of the health workers, in the case of the advocates, in the case of the managers, the practical experiences, the real-time situations make them to come to a conclusion and go for a research. Mostly in the business research also, the case studies, the exercises, all the experiences what they generally go through every time in decision making, that may act as a source for the experiencing as the research problem definition or research problem selection. A critical approach of literature. When one looks at books, articles, and summaries of clinical issues relating to the subject of our interest, pertinent questions may arise. Sometimes while studying the books, generally logically some doubts may arise in our mind, and that doubts, if we not solved, after some time they will formulate into a problem, and automatically the literature contributes something to our question, and that question makes us to select this as a problem for the research study. So this may strike the reader's mind by stimulating imagination and directly the additional research required into that. So the vision is improved, the imagination is created, the creativity is enhanced, and there is an innovation, and undoubtedly the literature goes to create a research problem in the mind. Next, the previous research. Sometimes the earlier researchers may contribute some questions which are unsolved in this particular research. That is what called as the future and scope of the research of the same problem or similar type of surrounding and depending problems. So that's why the scope for further research may also go for forming a research problem on the part of the researchers. Or at the end of the research dissertation or the action or report, some of the problems may be suggested in the course of the future course of time to go for a better investigation and conducting of surveys and to find out several solutions to the surrounding problems. So such type of things may come under the from the previous research. Next, what is the previous research? The previous research is nothing but the problems which are being used in the earlier researches. Next one, there is a connectivity between the various topics as shown in the slide. The research objectives or hypothesis, they also contribute some problem identification. The research aims or the objectives of the researcher may also contribute. The research problem or the questions before the researcher may also generate the research problem. Or sometimes the research gap or the gaps existing between and among the various solutions which are available in this arena may also go for the creation of the research problem. Next one is existing theories. The research is a process of theory development and theory testing. If an existing theory is used in developing a researchable problem, a specific statement from the theory must be isolated. Generally, a part or parts of a theory are subjected to testing in a clinical situation. The testing of a theory is needed, therefore they serve as a good source of research problem. So until and unless the existing theories are not tested, automatically there is no question of getting a better solution. So every time it is not confirmed that the existing theories may work out and create 100% satisfied results. Sometimes they may be failed. So automatically the upgradation comes in the form of testing the existing theories. The social issue. Sometimes the issues of global, contemporary or political issues of relevance are suggested. The idea for a research may stem from a familiarity with social concern or controversial social issues. Sometimes we find out some yes-no situations in the society also. After a huge struggle between the yes and no answers for a given situation or a solution or a problem, automatically the further questions will arise and that may emerge into the research problem. Next, brainstorming sessions. So when the people go on discussing between and among themselves as a groups or a group discussions, that may be intensified discussions among the interested people of the same profession or equal capacity or equal calibered people. Automatically some ideas are formulated and some problems may arise out, and through that a good research problem can be stemmed out or created. The intuition. In general, some of the people do have some innate energies or innate thoughts. The intuitions are called as inborn situations or inborn desires. So the inborn desires are considered good source of knowledge as well as source to find out new research problems. It is believed that reflective mind is a good source of idea, which may be used to find out new and good research problems. Automatically the innate energies or the innate urge of a person to go for solving a problem or to feel a problem, and that may create a research problem and do lead for a good research. The folklore. Sometimes while observing among our society and other people, and we may come to a conclusion that what is the right and what is the wrong between the ethics and norms what we practice. Some common beliefs that can be called as folklore. And from that common beliefs, we may sometimes go for taking of some unsolving situations in the common beliefs and ethics or practices being observed in the society. So such type of things may be taken by a researcher, and a survey can be conducted or an examination can be conducted or a testing can be conducted, and do may lead for a researcher in the future course. Exposure to the field situation. Sometimes we go for data collection or observations in the field, and we may have a variety of experiences, and due to that so many ideas may generate on the part of us when we are in the field in the actual situation, and those ideas may lead towards the formation of a research problem. Then the consultation with the expert. Generally it is also said by our teachers when we are conducting our PhD course or MPhil course, that you go and speak to the experts in the relevant areas, and they have a lot of exposure on that, and they go for interaction with them, and after discussion our vision is cleared, our area is exposed, and automatically we found that what is not, what is right, and what should be there in the research problem, and how to go for defining a better research problem. So the experts are believed to have sound experience of their respective field, which may suggest a significant problem to the study. So in addition, experts may help in finding a current problem of discipline to be solved, which may serve as a basis for the formulation of the research problem. So I hope you might have all understood how actually the research problem is to be selected, and what is the importance of the research problem in the arena of research, and how a good definition of a research problem will be, and selection and definition of a research problem will be going to lead and ultimately result into a successful research study and solutions for the existing research problems. With this, I hope that you might have understood what is the nature and significance of the research problem selection, and I hope that you might have gone through some of the things related to this in your books or the material available to you. Thank you. I hope you are all go for once again watching the same videos in future course of time, such that you may have a concrete way of understanding what is a research problem selection, how it is to be done, and what is the importance of it in the research activity and the research process. So till then, stay safe and stay protected. Thank you. Thank you very much.